नमस्कार, आई एम सीएस केके अग्रवाल, योर वेरी ओन टैक्स फैकल्टी। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द लेक्चर ऑफ सर्विस टैक्स पार्ट टू। बिफोर आई स्टार्ट, लेट मी इन्फॉर्म यू ऑफ द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ दीज लेक्चर्स। दीज लेक्चर्स कैन बी डाउनलोडेड ऑन योर मोबाइल फोन, देयर बाय यू कैन लर्न टैक्स एनी टाइम anywhere. You can visit my website taxbykk.blogspot.com. Here all the contents are constantly updated. Don't miss it. Now let us start from where we have left. Friends, let us revise the most important sections again. I have made groups which are shown in boxes. Section 64, Section 65, 65A, Section 66, 66A, Section 67, 68, 69, 70, Section 75, Section 76, Section 94. Now, let us discuss the first section, Section 64 of the Finance Act 1994, which talks about extent, commencement and applicability. But before we discuss section 4, let us discuss the word India. This is map of India. The landmass, that is geographical boundary area, which you see inside the blue circle is called domestic tariff area. Tariff area is that area in which government is authorized to levy tax. Any area outside the landmass or domestic tariff area is called foreign territory. And in foreign territory, government is not authorized to levy any tax. This golden rule is applicable to all types of taxes, whether direct tax or indirect tax. There are certain areas in DTA which can be called special economic zone. The government notifies these area as SEZ as per SEZ Act 2005. SEZ is that industrial colony where any goods are manufactured for compulsory export. Right now, around 17 SEZ are in operation all over India. Let us call all orange patches as an area of SEZ. Now, the question is whether government can levy any tax in these SEZ? The answer is yes, if you follow the golden rule. But government do not levy any kind of taxes in these areas only because SEZ helps India to earn precious foreign exchange. There are two ways of not levying tax. One, do not levy service tax in the first stage itself. Or number two, allow SEZ to first pay service tax and then it can be claimed as refund. For this, we have to read section 93. It talks about power to grant exemption from service tax. This section we would do at later stage. Now let us talk about Jammu and Kashmir. You can watch the video of SEZ in taxbykk.blogspot.com. J&K enjoys special status in Constitution of India. Before central government passes a law, it obtains concurrence of J&K. Now, J&K Legislative Assembly gives its consent, then law is applicable to whole of India, including J&K. J&K Legislative Assembly do not gives it consent, the law is applicable to whole of India except Jammu and Kashmir. Section 64, Extent, Commencement and Application. This chapter extends to whole of India except the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Chapter means Chapter 5 of the Finance Act 1994. Except the state of J&K implies any services provided in the state of J&K is not subjected to service tax. Now, what is the meaning of India? Does it include only landmass or it also includes the sea area? We have already discussed India includes landmass, that is geographical boundary of India or domestic tariff area except Jammu and Kashmir. Now, does India also includes sea area? For this, we have to read territorial waters, continental shelf, exclusive economic zone and other Maritime Zone Act 1976. In short, let us call it Maritime Zone Act 1976. Let us read the relevant sections of Maritime Zones Act 1976. As per Section 3, Maritime Zones Act 1976, India includes territorial water of India, that is up to 12 nautical miles from the baseline. There was a big controversy in Customs Act 1962 whether India includes water beyond 12 nautical mile. All these controversies have been put to rest in all direct and indirect tax laws. Now, as per Section 7 of Maritime Zones Act 1976, exclusive economic zone is an area beyond and adjacent to the territorial waters, and the limit of such zone is 200 nautical miles from the baseline, and it will be treated as part of India for all direct and indirect tax laws. If I draw the diagram from the baseline, it will look like this. 12 nautical mile from the baseline is territorial waters of India. Any services provided in territorial waters of India is subjected to service tax. 200 nautical miles from the baseline is called exclusive economic zone. Beyond 200 nautical miles is called high seas. Any services provided in high seas is not subjected to service tax. Do remember, if I draw 200 nautical mile as it is, then Sri Lanka becomes part of India. Therefore, this law has international ramification. Let us see actual EEZ from the point of view of India. The portion shown in blue is EEZ. The portion beyond EEZ is called high seas / foreign territory. Now the question is whether provisions of service tax is applicable if services are provided in EEZ. For this, we have to read the notification number 14/2010. This we will do in service tax part 3. Thank you.